me, you know my wife, Martha, just before I left the house, Mayor, she said, where are you going? And I said, I'm going into town and going to have an unveiling of a statue of former Mayor Jim Sills. She said, what's been named after you? I said, nothing. And years ago, we raised $10 million to overhaul the Wilmington train station, make it shine on its 100th anniversary. They named after Joe Biden. I've been elected 14 times statewide, anybody in history. And I have nothing. Mayor, I just want to say something that I once heard Joe Biden say, and it said, flattery won't hurt you if you don't inhale. You're going to get a lot of flattery today. So hold your breath. Some of you know my wife, Martha. Just before I left the house, Mayor, she said, where are you going? And I said, I'm going into town and going to have an unveiling of a statue of former Mayor Jim Sills. And she says, they're not going to name anything after him, are they? And I said, well, they already have. And they said, well, she said, what's been named after you? I said, nothing. She said, how about that combined water sewer overflow under the city of Wilmington? It's still there. And it bears my name. You got yourself a bridge, now a statue. This is not right. I've been elected 14 times statewide, anybody in history, and I have nothing. 10 years ago, we raised $10 million to overhaul the Wilmington train station, make it shine on its 100th anniversary. They named after Joe Biden. I get no respect. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the two best governors ever to serve the state of Delaware, John Carney.
I don't know what he had for breakfast, but I want some of that. Well, Senator, you can go home and tell Martha that there's a bridge now that's off the list. And a corner where a statue's going to be that's off the list as well. Martha and TC seem to be fixated on that. What are they going to name after Tom after he goes?
And by the way, you all can see Tom Carper perform at the Queen on Saturdays. Get there before 6. You don't have to pay the cover charge.
Great to see Julie. How are you, babe? Nice to see you. I was going nowhere as governor until we hired her. I tell you, you and Evelyn raised 3 kids that anybody would be proud to call their own. And when I was privileged to be governor, the 8 years, if I'm not mistaken, you were a mayor for those 8 years. And we had an opportunity to work on a bunch of stuff together, including Mike Przinka got involved. We hired Mike Przinka to help do the riverfront, transformed to really just an industrial wasteland where nobody went there, nothing grew, nobody lived there. Transformed it into what it is to today. Took a part of Wilmington that was going down, broke, not enough money to put into to anything. And with the help of the legislature and all mayor's guidance and support, we transformed it into the top banana port in America, the Port of Wilmington. Let's hear it for the Port of Wilmington. One of the things that I remember Jim Sills saying to me when I was governor, he said, in order for Delaware to be successful, Wilmington has to be successful. Think about that. In order for Delaware to be successful, Wilmington has to be successful. And he and I worked for 8 years together to try to make sure that both the state of Delaware and the city of Wilmington were successful. And they both are successful today, I think far more successful than they otherwise would have been because of his leadership. A lot of times I like to quote other people. Today I'm going to quote myself. I was looking for something great that I could quote and talking about your leadership, Mayor, and I said, why don't I just write something? And maybe this will make me famous too. We'll see. I don't know. But it goes something like this. Leaders are humble, not haughty. They have the heart of a servant. They understand that their job is to serve, not to be served. Leaders have the courage to stay out of step when everyone else is marching to the wrong tune. Leaders unite, not divide. They build bridges, not walls. Leaders surround themselves with the best people they can find. And when their team does well, the leader gives the credit to his or her team. When the team falls short, the leader takes the blame. Leaders don't build themselves up by bringing others down. Leaders are aspirational. They appeal to our better angels. As Albert Camus once said, that leaders are purveyors of hope. Think of that, purveyors of hope. And he was right. And finally, leaders always seek to do what's right, not what is easy or expedient. Leaders treat other people the way they want to be treated. They focus on excellence in everything they do. If it isn't perfect, let's make it better. And finally, when leaders know they are right, they never, never, never give up. Jim Sills never gave up. It was an inspiration to me and to many that are here and many that have gone on in the past. Thank you for being our leader. Thank you for being my friend. Thank you for being a great inspiration to all of us. Mayor, congratulations.